Hello, my friends. Welcome, my friends. Welcome to another episode of Breakfast with Sergio. This is episode number 67. So that's the topic for today, my friends, here on Breakfast with Sergio. How to avoid the typical art scams that may be coming your way. So what's for breakfast today? Well, today I have a croissant, a delicious looking croissant from the Bagler's Coffee House here in Chicago in Lincoln Park. They make the best croissants and bagels in Chicago. You have to try them, the Bagler's Coffee House. Every day they are baked fresh, and that's what I made. That's what I have today, a croissant from the Bagler's Coffee House. I slice it in two, and then inside I have just egg white. So it's almost like an egg white croissant. So it's super good, super delicious. That's what's on my breakfast today. And as before I do that, I wanna share with you really quickly something that happens often, art scams, how to avoid art scams, things that you can do as an artist to protect yourself from art scams. And my friends, thank you for the comments. Welcome to Breakfast with Sergio once again. Let me know what you're having for breakfast. I always enjoy reading that as well. All right, so there are all kinds of art scams. The first one, the ones that comes through email, right? The typical email scam looks like this, and they change over time. I've seen them all, of all kinds. The typical one that's going out right now comes through your email and says, hey, you know, Sergio, my wife's anniversary is coming up, or her birthday is coming up, and I have seen her browsing your website. So I want to give her a surprise. Please send me what's available. What works are available on your website. That's the typical art scam that's out right now. Watch out for that. You know, that's sort of, the language changes a little bit, but that's pretty much the idea. I saw my wife looking at your website. Let me know what you have available, right? So what will happen is then the artist will send what is available, and then they will say, well, okay, you know, I like this piece or that one. I will send you a cashier's check, in the mail, I'm gonna FedEx it, and so on. They start giving you, you know, all these options on how that person plans to make the payment, right? How they plan to make the purchase. So be careful, that's a big art scam out there right now. Another one is a person who says, I've been looking at your website, I really like this work or that work. Can you please confirm the price of that? What's the price of it? Then the artist sends the price, and then the person says, "Well, you know, I'm right now traveling out of the country, so I will send you a cashier's check. It will be coming in by, you know, FedEx or what have you, and then you can, you know, send me the artwork and so on." So, be careful. Those are big ad scams. How to avoid them? Well, one of the ways in which you avoid them is you have to first make sure that you always, you know, when you sell your work of art, you sell it at your terms. You decide the payment method you want to use. Don't let them decide what payment method, you know, they are going to use. You are making the sale. You decide, you know, the payment method, right? So I suggest that you use something like PayPal and have them pay through PayPal, because then you can have a record of the transaction. Never ship your artwork until it has been paid in full, including the shipping, right? Always charge for the shipping, plus the artwork, and any other fee that you may have, you know, handling or, you know, creating the work or what have you. Always have them pay. So to avoid a scam, you gotta accept the payment at your terms, not at their terms. That's where the scam comes from. They'll send you a supposed check that is really not valid, or you know, it will bounce back, or the funds will be removed and so on. Because through PayPal, once you send the artwork, then you can go to PayPal and put the tracking number so that it will be certified that it is received. And that way they cannot go back to PayPal and remove, you know, and cancel the transaction because it has already been received. So you gotta be careful. Always sell at your terms, not at the terms of the person, you know, sending you the email, right? That's a big one. Be careful with those, you know, the typical, my wife has been looking at your website. That right away, you know, that is a big scam that's going out right now. And always sell at your terms. Another one that comes through directly to your website. The person goes through your website and they use your contact form in your website. Again, same deal. You know, I've been looking at your work. It's wonderful. Maybe it's for me or for a gift. I'm overseas right now. I'm on a trip right now. So I'm gonna ship you. I'm gonna send you the payment, a cashier's check or what have you. You know, by FedEx and so on. So please confirm. You know, the price of the work. Again, big scam right there. Be careful with that. They always have to buy at your terms, not at their terms. Right? That's a big. Way in which you can avoid an art scam is to always have a method, a system, which you decide what it is, and they have to follow. If they say, well, sorry, I don't have PayPal, well, you know, I'm sorry, but it's, all you have to do is sign up for it, right? It's super easy. It is, you can sign up for free on paypal.com, right? So always be firm on your terms of sale and never let them decide what the terms of sale are, right? Unless they can come to your studio and pay you in cash, you know, that's a different story. Well, or with a credit card in your studio in person, that is another way. But otherwise, you know, the typical art scams is somebody who's overseas trying to buy your art and trying to make payment with some sort of check or cashier's bond or something like that. So be careful with those. And a lot of times come through email. Sometimes now they're getting a little bit fancier and they go to your website first and they use your contact form in your website. So be careful with those art scams. Another one is the exhibition scam. This one is the exhibition scam. This one is not about buying art, but it's rather about inviting you for a show, maybe in New York or in Paris or in Brazil, usually somewhere exotic, somewhere that artists will say, ooh, wow, you know, this is awesome. And they say how much they love your art, you know, how much they've been looking at your website, and they want to invite you to participate in this show. Sometimes it might be a biennial of some sort that they come up with. And but the reason this is a scam in my book is because they don't tell you upfront what's entailed. So the purpose is to entice the artist, right? Entice the artist on this big opportunity to exhibit internationally. And the artist gets excited and they ask you to send images, or maybe you send the artwork, I mean the images, and they select two or three. And then towards the end, you know, after email three or four, they send you the agreement. And in the agreement, then in fine print, you will find that actually to participate in this big opportunity that they invite you to be part of, now it's actually going to cost you, you know, 2,000 euros or 1,200 euros or, you know, $1,500, right? So, you know, be careful with those, you know. And then a lot of artists, because they are already kind of all enticed in this invitation, you know, to exhibit internationally, they're scrambling around trying to find the money to pay and participate in this sort of exhibition. Be careful with those, my friends. You know, it's a way in which some people are making big business. You know, imagine, you know, if they're charging 2,000 euros per artist, if they have 50 artists, you know, just do the math. It's a lot of money that they already made upfront just by artist participation in this show or biennial or whatever it may be. So be careful with those. Always check out when somebody invites you for a show, somebody invites you. The first thing you gotta do, if you don't know who they are, just go to good old Google, right? Go to good old Google and Google them up. See if you can find information on who they are, what kind of shows they have in the past. See if you can find other artists who have participated in the show. Look them up in social media, you know, see if they are legit or it is, again, it is a another one of those organizations or galleries or what have you. Or people that are just trying to create a one quick show to make a lot of money and then they disappear. So be careful with those as well. So those are the exhibition scams. And there's many out there. So you gotta be careful when they come around as well. Another one is the Instagram scam. The Instagram scam is another one where, you know, now they're using Instagram and it comes to Instagram and they say, I love your art. It's awesome. We'd love to feature you in whatever, you know, this or that. And when you go to the link, now you'll find that actually it's not really an invitation. They're just asking you, you know, if they want to feature you, you have to pay a fee for to be featured, right? So it's really advertising. It's not really, you know, a legit invitation because they love your art. No, it's just because they want to make money out of every person that they feature. So be careful with that. If it's not upfront, they don't tell you upfront what it is, and you find out later, well, just be careful. Another one, the last one, is the magazine scams. Another one that's going around, the magazine scam or the art book scam, where you get this email says inviting you to be part of this awesome magazine that they send to, you know, hundreds of galleries in the around the world, and the big collectors will get this magazine, and you can be part of that magazine, and they paint it really nicely, but it's going to cost you, you know, $1,000 or $700, you know, to be featured in the magazine. So that really is not an invitation. It's a marketing scheme to get you enticed in this magazine and participate, because it's supposedly going to go to, you know, hundreds of galleries all over the world and so on. But you know where the magazines end up, you know, most of the time, in the garbage, right? Galleries get a lot of mail. It is really, really not really the best thing to spend your money on. So, however, you know, again, there are some good opportunities out there. There are some good opportunities. So you have to be careful to decide which ones are good, legit, and which ones are not, right? Which ones are just marketing schemes. So be careful with that, my friend. Next time you get one of those big invitations, if it sounds too good, always check, fact check it. That's where you have the internet. Don't get scammed by some of these people who are out there getting a lot of money from artists and not giving anything back. And everybody can promise exposure, but what kind of exposure, that is a different question. So my friend, thanks so much for watching Brainfuck with Sergio. Hope you have a good day today. Avoid those scams, and we'll see you later, my friend. Take care, bye.